It's a very technical matter. But the important point to note is that it's all about celebration of World Human Rights Day. So my approach is not to focus on judges' rule. Although I cannot disobey, you want me to talk about judges' rule? We'll talk about judges' rule. But we must situate it in the context of the celebration of World Human Rights Day. It's necessary. What is human rights? It's those rights that we have by virtue of being human beings. No one human being has the right to take away the right of another human being. There are different types of human rights, and they are all important. But let me start by talking about the right to life. Not even your parents conferred that right on you. As a human being, you have a right to life. If you go to maternity, then the bomb begins. Or the side of the house, or the back of the house, for poor people, where the bomb begins. You don't ever see anything with a bond. Change day, man. No. So we are born free. It's the wicked ones that look for opportunities to put chains in the hands of their fellow human beings. Some put it on their hands, put it on their leg, put it across their mouth, make them not speak. So right from that day, that fight to assert our humanity began. I asked someone, one man, one pass another man, one man, one pass woman, both man and woman, they one pass begin for children. They begin to put all kinds of things. Whereas when we are born free. So, there are types of human rights. Fella sang one song long time ago. Tell me this, oh, tell me. Let me talk my own. We have a right to talk about our own. You can't bottle up my ideas. And that right of free speech is collective. Because you can't talk to yourself. You're talking to others. So if you look at how freedom of expression, the right of free speech, is coined in our constitution, it says you have a right to receive ideas and to impact ideas. In Nigeria that we find ourselves today, you say something where a fellow human being, not like, what do you call that? He said a hate speech. If other people hear that, maybe they go first, go do some kind of things. For that reason, not only are they trying to bottle up your ideas inside of you, they can even hang you for expressing before now. It's okay. If somebody talks something that is not true about you, this man don't enjoy my reputation. Don't call me thief, man, not be thief. You go give that man the opportunity to come and show that true, true. If you say I'm a thief, proven. Let me call him for me. Oji marama o, anti oji. But truth is always a defense. So yes, you are a thief. The money where you get, we're supposed to build of our own. How do you take to it? This one where you build your, this model where you all this bank account, how? What happened to Uso Akalu yesterday? So rather than providing the opportunity for whoever calls another one a thief to actually prove say a thief, so that if you not feel proven, they say you have injured his image. Go and pay him to so and so amount. In the Nigeria we are in today, that's not what they are concerned with. They say, Abba Jalingo, he called Ayade, the governor of Cross River State, call him thief. Money we give to microfinance bank, we take from them. Make it go explain how that money be you. That would have been the case before now. But what did they call the offense now? They said that treason. And they put handcuffs on your hands instead they want to back to court. So they, for trial, they said, no, nobody must see the witnesses. Where you want to prove, say, Abba Jalingo has committed treason. The right to fair hearing. Omo noma ye nunu me nege boye gbe me. If you don't hear my voice, you don't hear my own side, please don't pass judgment. I'm interfacing between our parables in my beautiful language and English just to show one point. That Ebo Male, Mama Rebogede, not be white people teach us about human rights. We already had our notions about human rights. How can the trial of Abba Jalingo be between SSS, the judge, and only Abba Jalingo? All the people who want to give evidence against them, nobody will see them. Whereas, ordinarily, if all these surgeons, doctors, want to do what they call operations, they will cover their mouth. They will lock them. So when they forget scissors inside person belly, nobody will know. Even the nurses waiting they see there, they know they talk about that. But in matters of liberty, trial is public. So that's why you can go to court anytime. Journalists get their own desk as far as they. If the judge is judging right, our work will say people will see her. We could follow the logic. If the lawyer is doing well, if the witness is telling true, beyond the judge and the lawyers, those where you don't look, they will be following. So if they don't judge the case well, our government will be people where they see her. They say, which kind of judgment be that? Somebody had expressed his opinion. You say he has committed treason. These are people who come back us a few days ago for our vote. Now you have become governor. You are pretending that the tenure of your office is not limited. You think you'll be there for the rest of that kingdom. You forget that we the people, like we talked just now, say the land is ours. Yeah. Now we give small out of our lives, give you, Mr. Governor. And for a short period of time, now you don't become, somebody criticizes you and say, ah, don't commit treason. That's what the Nigeria won't let you. What is what they do? What is dog? What is a revolution? A revolution is a fundamental change. People wake up and say they don't bring change. They say somebody will say you want to bring change, waiting deeper than all these their cosmetics. You don't commit treason. Hard for a long time. We'll come to judges. They said that treason will commit. For even talking about change, fundamental change, that all this change, favoritism, where we're going to charge one, you leave the other one. Somebody come and talk, say, look, all you need to do is to come to our side. Then all your sins are forgiven. That's the way, express in opinion. That this one will not be changed. The one where Nigeria lives is deeper than this. That call for revolutionary change. They say they want that. I was discussing with my colleagues here. Me, I've never seen that though. When you say you grant mercy, babe, you go bring a shorty, maybe say, you're not going to ever find. On top of that, that shorty go come put 100 million down. If they charge Agwamobude, say before they can give him freedom now, let me go bring his friend. After putting his house down, after putting his job, everything on the line, make still go bring 100 million cash, come put for ground. Been practicing for almost 40 years. I've never seen that kind of condition. So what we are witnessing is a situation where judges are anticipating how Mr. President feels. This man, when they talk, say, I don't become enemy of Mr. President. I'm going to make life so difficult for him that the conditions I'm going to give to him, he can never meet it. But he forgets, say, some Nigerians, they will get sorry at. When you know, say, they just worry this man for the truth when he talk. The judge, even the laughing. Yeah? So whatever all the friends where you get, you don't have to bring 100 million come court. Until the lawyer go file application, they amend the conditions of bail. At the end of meeting the conditions of bail, court officials went to verify the houses where those people say they get, their bank account. When she says they get that kind of money for accounts, it's already wrong. Who be DSS? That will talk after that and say, well, others want to say, judge, accept. We don't accept. What? An equal man of government? You are just one small agency in the executive arm. The man was there for months, even after the court had said, bring him to court, let him come and sign the recognition so he can go. DSS forget, say they charged this man to court on the 5th of December, the trial is supposed to start, so they couldn't keep him indefinitely. Come yesterday, and the judge tells you, I give you 24 hours. Don't release this man. You see what will happen to you. The judge speaks on behalf of all of us. all the powers vested in the army, the police, and the rest of us. We are supposed to be able to use to enforce the orders of the court. And that is what the DSS will have to contend with. What happened? They granted him bail yesterday. The trial was supposed to start today. The trial was adjourned till February. They don't call another matter because the court was done with that one. Make sure Ore get up, make it go. CSS say they want to arrest her. What did he do again? So in the final analysis, they just pretended that they complied with the court order. And what we are hearing now is that, oh, maybe there is another offense. So the first one, what the first charge them for, they don't grab their bail for that one. This one now is different. How many charges do you have against Obayuwana? There's a provision for amending charges between now and February when the matter is to come back up. You have every opportunity to do that. He started to fight with his comrades, dragged him down while the judge was seated there, trying to attend to other matters. So, ladies and gentlemen, as the president of the Committee for the Defense of Human Rights, we just issued a statement of that. What is at stake is his right to liberty, his right to fair hearing. I don't know how many of you saw the statement made by the mother. We are dealing with people who cannot face Boko Haram. We are dealing with people who are negotiating with bandits, even with their rifles. They come into the village, they take like 10 or 15 people. The governor said, come now, let's talk about this issue. They said, go and bring me 500 million. As they are coming for the meeting with the governor, they have their rifles with them. DSS will not be doing anything concerning that situation. They want to kill this man, this young man. For doing what? For exercising his freedom of speech. So, this is a statement that we just issued a few minutes ago. For re-arrest is on the platform of the CDHR, Committee for the Defense of Human Rights. Incidentally, the logo of our own organization is exactly this one. Yes. Because it's our duty to break these chains. When we were born, we didn't come with chains. Anybody wearing a good chain for your hand, break it. Defend your rights and help others to defend their rights. They don't get three hands, they don't get four hands. There's equality. That's only two hands and one head and two legs. Now all of us get. The CDHR receives with utmost shock the news of the rearrest by the DSS of Omoyele Sowore, a patriot of the finest new in Abuja. One day after the DSS reluctantly complied with the order of court, having been in contemptuous defiance for an unbelievably long period of time. While the DSS further violates by this rearrest the rights of Omoyele Sowore, it has exposed itself as an agency of government that cannot be taken seriously. Given the lame excuses spewed forth not too long ago for their flagrant violation of the rule of law and human rights in our dear country. At a point, you will recall, ladies and gentlemen, their information officer trivialized the issues by saying that the Omoyele Sowore and others were so comfortable in DSS custody that they would rather stay there indefinitely. You heard it.
Yes.
At another time, they said The court order to release Obayuwana was being disobeyed, according to the DSS, to prevent him from being run over by an unmarked vehicle.
You know these are gentlemen, there are certain birds, if you put them inside the cage, they don't survive that experience. Because they want to spread their wings. He said, Buhari, how many of those governors with his double standard? Ambrose Ali was one of them. When they released him, how long did Ambrose Ali live? The man who cannot walk where he wants to walk, or refuse to walk if he doesn't want to walk. This is what I think is a joke. Unfortunately for them, the issue of observance of human rights, democracy, and good governance is not a comical show. This will not be comedy. It's serious. You take away the sense of worth of a human being when you lock him up. Wickedness is high and low places. Remember this case of the young man that was staying with the aunt in Lagos. Say thief meat for soup. He go put him inside dog cage. Tell you wickedness of man. So Nigerians have shown that we are not amused. This one will be a comedy show. In fact, this is captured. Even at some point, the judge was also playing hide and seek. How is your millionaire friend? Why they not come? But he got to a stage where she couldn't take it anymore. And that's why she gave the ultimatum. I give you 24 hours to release this man. From all indications, ladies and gentlemen, the DSS realized that the game was up. By quickly complying, pretending to release him only for a few hours. The crude rearrest of Sowore and Bakare within the court premises, where they had gone to answer to the charges against them. They know they cannot prove the charge. You grant them a, okay, bring your witnesses now. They can't go on. Is that same court where they went to answer to the charges? That's where you are rearresting them. This is not only an insult to the judiciary as an institution and the system of administration of justice as a whole. It's a spite on all that is decent about Nigeria and world opinion. It conveys in unmistakable terms that the present leadership and membership of the DSS as an agency of government is completely out of tune with the dictates of the rationale for the establishment of the DSS and the mandate that it is supposed to carry out. The charade and shenanigans of their orchestrated, completely unconstitutional secret trials of those who have been criminalized for expressing their views had already shown that the agency has outlived its usefulness in present-day Nigeria. This crude abduction of Sowore confirms beyond all doubt that the DSS as presently composed is nothing but a lapdog that sees its job as not going beyond the preoccupation of imagining the expectations of persons holding office for a limited period of time, even when no express direction has been given to them. We are reminded of the onslaught against the National Assembly in the absence of Mr. President a few years ago. You remember? Mr. President was sick in hospital in England. There were rumors that the National Assembly
be making some moves against him. You remember the distant DSS? When the national has seen the place up. At the point where nobody sent them. So they are playing to the gallery of somebody who is in office for a very limited period of time. And it's very dangerous. Even when they were not sent. They choose to write drugs over the rights and interests of the Nigerian people to whom sovereignty lies at all times. This land is ours. So this matter, we emphasize, goes beyond the reshuffling of the leadership of the DSS. It's not a question of saying, let their director go. The entire composition of the DSS, from the top to the bottom, having shown itself to be unworthy, should be disbanded. There's a business. The older ones amongst us will remember that we once had an outfit called the NSO. Was the NSO not disbanded? Yes. SSS or DSS, as they now call themselves, have completely outlived their usefulness. That organization is beyond redemption. It has to be dissolved immediately. Call on the Nigerian people and the NDA to insist on this. And the National Assembly to side with the Nigerian people. To repeal the law that established the DSS. Sack all its personnel and by legislation lay the foundation for a new security system agency focused on the protection of the well-being of all Nigerian people as opposed to the emerging interest of the few of his controllers in Nigeria. That is the statement we have just issued. Over to the other. That deals with the right to liberty. Now, in 1948, what we are actually celebrating today, 1948, because of the atrocities and the inhumanity of one man to another, the whole world came together and adopted India. We outlined the different types of rights, political rights, civil rights, economic rights, social rights, cultural rights, children's rights, women's rights, the rights of minorities, the right to self-determination. Right is right. All these rights are intertwined. You cannot separate them. But what is clear is there is equality of rights, equality of obligations, and freedom from discrimination. We talk about the right to free speech, the right to fair hearing, freedom of movement, the right to liberty, the right to own property, the right to the dignity of your human person. Anybody that locks you. Of course, we've talked about the right to life. There used to be people who consider themselves free to say, look, bring down my gun, I will shoot you. To create the life of a fellow citizen. Because of the atrocities that Hitler perpetrated against the Jews. Of course, we argue that it is double standard. Because the greatest form of human rights violation has been the trade in enslaved persons. The enslavement of the African was the greatest atrocity ever committed in the history of man. but it took the killing of about 6 million Jews. The number of Africans that died in the slave trade is much more than that. So these rights that have been established since 1948, what we are witnessing today is that there are people who will still want to take these rights away. Trafficking to send a young girl to a street corner in Italy to sleep with 100 men in one night. The entirety of the amount that she got paid, some madam to take it from her and say, I got the ticket, I gave you the visa to come here. You will slave for me for 2-3 years before you can receive your freedom. 70 years or 68 years after the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So what this emphasizes is eternal vigilance. If you don't fight for your rights, they'll be taken away from you. Where did Bellator? Human rights. Now, judges rule. I just used all of that to give you the background. This is what is being celebrated today. December 10th, 1948 was the day that the whole world is entitled to all these rights, without derogation. That is what we are celebrating. In a country like ours, when there's a serious assault, somebody wants to pretend that he's so caring about Nigeria that nobody must talk. Nobody must criticize him. You don't love Nigeria more than us. And the point that we are making is, if you don't fight for your rights, they'll be taken away from you. Now, judges rule relates to the administration of justice. There are certain basic canons that we have come to accept, that it is better for 99 otherwise guilty persons to go free than for one man who is innocent to be punished for what he did. It took a lot of experience before we came to that conclusion. That is why we have presumption of innocence. If you are accused of any offense, you don't even have to say anything. Let the person who is accusing you be the one to prove the offense. And there's a standard of proof. It must be proved beyond reasonable doubt. So that before society punishes, we are assured that truly, truly, this person did what society said shouldn't be done. So it's in protection of our collective interest that we say, please, don't do this again. I send you to go and cool your heels so that you can reflect on what you are.